Hey everyone, welcome back. This is Motion UX and I'm Ivan Wittaborg. Today we're going to be diving in how do we take our designs from Figma and bring them into After Effects using a tool called AE UX. So let's dive in now. AE UX is a plugin for Figma and a plugin for After Effects that allows us to seamlessly send our designs from Figma into After Effects and start to animate them there. So this is amazing, right? Because we're able to design in the tool that's best fitted for UI and UX design, which is Figma. And yet we're still able to leverage After Effects to do our animation. Redesigning all of those screens that we've beautifully designed in Figma in After Effects would be such a high level of effort. And so this cuts out that middle process and just allows us to import our designs very seamlessly into After Effects. So if we go to AE UX, we can go ahead and we can download the latest version. If we go ahead and open up AE UX, we see that we have stuff for Sketch, we got stuff for Figma, and we have stuff for After Effects. So let's go ahead and do the After Effects one. As you can see here, it's using a .zxp extension. And so if we actually use our ZXP installer, which you can get from AE Scripts. So all you do is drag and drop and it installs it into the appropriate application. So you can see in After Effects, now I have AE UX for all of these different versions of After Effects. Shows me the version of the plugin and so on. Now After Effects is up and running. We got that figured out. Next is Figma. So we get this manifest.json file format. And if you're familiar with Figma, typically you would go into Figma, you go to home and you'd search the community and you'd be able to download a plugin and install it directly into Figma, like with one click. Because this plugin is not published in that environment yet, we have to add it as if we are the developer of the plugin. We just right click when we're inside of a document, we go down to development and import plugin from manifest. Then we just navigate to that Figma folder and open up that manifest.json file. And now AE UX has been imported. And if you go back to the plugins development, you see we have AE UX as our new plugin. And if we actually go ahead and click that, we get this nifty panel right here to launch it. This plugin is still in development, so you'll definitely run into some bugs here and there. And usually just closing it and opening it back up fixes a lot of those bugs. And so I actually went ahead and created a keyboard shortcut using our system preferences just in the Mac, going to keyboard and creating an app shortcut specifically for AE UX. But I just set it to this hotkey here. And so whenever I'm not using it, I can just do Control Option Shift A. And it will relaunch that plugin. And if I do it while it's already launched and I hit it again, it will just refresh the plugin. So as you can see, this plugin is very, very simple. We got three options right here. And so one is whatever you have selected, you click it and it sends it over to After Effects. Then we have export reference image. What that will do is that will be essentially a PNG of what you have right here. Sometimes things get misaligned, especially with text layers, sometimes vector logos and things like that. And so it's nice to have that reference if we need to kind of like piece things back together if things break over the transfer. And then we have rasterized layer on export. And what this does, it's really wonderful for things like logos that are heavy with a lot of different vectors and paths and masks and things like that. A good rule of thumb of using this is asking yourself, do you need full control over animating this specific element on your design? And so for me, do I need to do like a logo animation here? And in this case, I don't. And so what I'm gonna do is select this logo layer and click rasterize layer on export. And you see it adds a little asterisk right here. And so what will happen is when I actually send the selection over to After Effects, it will basically create a PNG of this entire logo with its type right here. And that really helps limit the amount of resources needed to render all the things that are happening in After Effects. Typically, you won't be working in an isolated environment like this with just one screen. Like, you'll be working within your entire flow of a bigger project. Sometimes you need to break up the groups in specific ways, depending on like the bugs that you run in during the transfer. Sometimes you may need to rasterize specific layers and all of those sorts of things. And so what I find is helpful, if I only need to animate one or two screens, I'll just copy the screens, make a new Figma file, and dump things over there as my like animation export type of space so that I don't mess with the actual designs that the rest of the team is working on. Another thing that you will notice is we have all these auto layout groups here. When we import this selection to After Effects, it will basically convert all of those groups into comps within comps within comps. And there's a specific tool in the After Effects plugin that allows you to ungroup all of those comps. But if it's something that you want to avoid here, you can go ahead and like ungroup some of these things. But if it breaks your design using auto layout, then just keep it the same here. And when we get into After Effects, we'll actually deal with ungrouping things that we don't need to be comped up. Now that our designs are ready in Figma, let's hop over to After Effects and see what we need to do there. So now that we're here in After Effects, you'll see if we go under Window and Extensions, we'll have AEUX here. So right here off the bat, we have New Comp or Current Comp. And so what that will do, this is basically the settings that AEUX and Figma will look at as it's importing all those designs. And so if I select New Comp, every time I'm in Figma and I click Send Selection to After Effects, it will create a brand new composition to put all of those designs in. Sometimes you already have a composition set up and you just need to like bring this one little element, maybe this one button, into where you're currently working. And so that's where Current will be more helpful. And so it will import everything that you're working on into the current composition that you have open. Then we have image save paths. If there are images already in your design, or if you're going to be rasterizing any of the layers, it needs to save those images somewhere. We'll go ahead and we will go into AUX and we'll go to assets and we'll do new folder and we'll do AUX. And so I understand that these are things that AUX is using to import into my designs. And you can see every time I do that, it will save it to that place for this specific After Effects project. Now we have comp size multiplier. So in Figma, we can see that we're working at 320 pixels. And so if I send this selection to After Effects at 1x comp size, it will be a 320 pixel wide composition. That's fine, but if we actually go to export that, we're gonna be exporting a 320 pixel wide composition. And if we really want to blow this up so that we can see it at a high resolution, maybe we want to multiply that by like 2 or 3 so that we can make sure that we're having high resolution video comps at the end of this animation process. Typically, I stick with about 2x comp size multiplier when I'm working on mobile designs. When I'm working on desktop size designs, 1x comp size usually is okay, but it depends on kind of where that video spec or that animation is going to live at the end of the day. Then we have the frame rate. You can change this to whatever you need. Typically, I stick to 60 frames per second because that's a good balance of it's being really, really smooth. I'm able to set my like millisecond durations very easily with 60 frames per second. Then we have the comp size duration. And so we can change that from 5 seconds is the default, and we can change it to all the way up to whatever you want. And you can actually come in here and type in however long you want it to be. This is really dependent on what you're going for. If it's really just like showing a small little micro interaction, 5 seconds usually is plenty of time. If you're trying to show an entire flow, maybe you want like a minute, 2 minutes or something like that. So when we have this selected, detect parametric shapes. If you have a square or a circle, it will detect those shapes in After Effects as a square or circle layer. And if you're familiar with After Effects, you have a few more options in the properties of those shapes. Otherwise, it will just detect it as a path layer. So pre-comp groups. If in Figma we have anything that is an actual group, so currently we just have auto layout groups and we have frames. But if we actually have a Command G group, it will detect this as a group and it will make this into its own pre-comp. Otherwise, if it is a group and you do not have that selected, it will just parent those to a null object. Then in here, we have some group controls so we can pre-comp things. If we select a group of layers, we can pre-comp them. We can un-pre-comp things that have already been pre-comped. We can toggle guide visibility layers and we can delete all the group layers. And so deleting the group layers, sometimes there's just extra stuff that's imported from this process. So you may see some null objects, some guide layers. It will just kind of clean up all of those things that you don't necessarily need for animating. And then you have the versioning here below. And that is it. So let's go ahead and import our designs at 2x comp size multiplier for 5 seconds, 60 frames per second from Figma. We're going to select our login screen and we're going to send selection to After Effects. And it's building the layers. Everything's popped in. It already saved the images to where I told it to earlier. And now we are good to go. We can see that we have a comp called login screen. We have this auto layout group as a comp, the CTA group as a comp. And if we click into this, we can see that the logo has been replaced with an image. If we look back over at our Figma, we can see that it all is still its live vector groups and all of those sorts of things. So nothing in the Figma has been affected except for it added this little asterisk to let it know that this is going to be a raster layer. So now that everything's in After Effects, we really want to go ahead and clean things up and make sure everything's set up in the way that we want to start animating, deleting layers that we don't need and so on. Here you can see we have the toggle guide layer visibility in anytime a layer has this little blue hash mark, that is a guide layer. And you can see this right here is actually the login screen reference layer that we selected within our Figma file. So this export reference image, that's what that is. And it's automatically imported as a guide layer that has a slight bit of transparency on it. And so we're able to see what has lined up correctly and what has not. I also want to mention that you see that there is a blue background here that matches what we have in our Figma file. However, that background color is not an actual physical layer. And so if we were to export this from After Effects, it would export with a transparent background. You can actually see the transparency here. This is just the background color of the actual composition, but not an actual background solid. And so if we want to have that background solid, we need to actually select what that color is going to be. You can't actually eyedropper pick this. And so you can just come back into Figma and see what that fill color is, copy it, and paste that into this as a hex code. And so now if we send that to the background with Command Shift left bracket, it will send it to the bottom. And now we have an actual background layer. We really want to have the ability to move this logo around as well as this subtitle, but I don't want to have to keep on going back into this pre-comp every single time. And so I'm going to go ahead and un-pre-comp that. And you can see now we have the subtitle, we have the logo, and then you see this here is a shape layer that's over the entire thing. And the reason that this has been created is because this is essentially the bounding box of our auto layout group. And so you can see this is there, and it matches the same thing here. So these are just extra layers created in this import process. Sometimes you could find them helpful if you wanted to do a quick mask of the content that's inside of here. But typically I go ahead and delete those. Right now I don't really need have a use for them. And then down here at the CTA pre-comp, I wanna go ahead and un-pre-comp that. And you can see I have another group guide here. I'm going to delete that because it's not necessary. And we have the sign-in CTA over here. We have the auto layout group thing that's been imported as well. We don't need that. So let's go ahead and delete that. And then we have the sign up. And I'm just going to go ahead and reorder this to reflect the order that's actually here visually, just as a way to organize things as I'm going through. We're just going to go ahead and apply a very simple animation to this and then say that we are done. So we're going to go ahead and do maybe a position and opacity. I'm doing that by pressing P to open up position, holding Shift T, and then that opens up opacity. And I'm just gonna do a real simple fade in on all of these. And so I have all of the keyframes turned on. I'm gonna do Command Shift, right arrow, right arrow, right arrow to move 30 frames to the right and add another keyframe. This is where I want them to be when the animation is done. So we're gonna go back to the beginning of the timeline and we're gonna move everything down a few pixels by holding Shift and pressing down. And then the opacity is gonna go to zero. And then we're gonna go ahead and add some easing. And you can do that by doing F9, and that will go ahead and do a default easy ease. Otherwise I use a plugin called Flow, and I'll do another video on this specifically and how we use it to keep our animations consistent, but I'll go ahead and add my easing there. And you can see that now everything fades in really nice. And now I wanna add a slight offset. And so I want the top to go in first and the bottom to come in last. And this is one reason why I organize my layers like this, so I can easily at a glance be able to offset some of my layers. So if I go ahead and tap U, we'll hide all those keyframes. Grab this, move it 2, grab this, move it 4, grab this, move it 6. And if I play it now, you can see things come in a little bit more staggered. And we have a nice little animation of our login screen. All right, everyone. So we just went through the entire workflow of how do we get our designs from Figma into After Effects using AE UX. The goal is always how do we get quicker in our motion design workflow. And this allows us to get to animating as quickly as we possibly can. Catch you guys next time. Thank you.